Hi, welcome to the statics tutorials. So here's another option sometimes that you'll see. The problems will say minimize the resultant. So we're going to find the magnitude of this unknown force vector, F1, to make the resultant be of the resultant of F1, this vector, be as small as possible. So I've labeled this vector F2 and this vector F3. We're just going to break them up into their components. So F1 has a 3-4-5 right triangle on it. So its x component is going to be 3/5 of F1. So that would be 0.6 times F1 using a decimal instead of a fraction. And then F1y would be equal to 4/5 times F1, which gives us the 0.8 times F1 using a decimal instead of the fraction. F1 is going in the positive x direction, but negative y direction, so we have a positive sign here and a negative sign here. For F2, this vector is having a 45 degree angle to the x-axis, so F2x is going to be its magnitude times cosine of 45, F2y is its magnitude times sine of 45. This x component is going in the negative x direction, so negative here. And this y component looks like it's going in the negative y direction, so we have a negative here for the y component. And then for F3, F3 contains a vector going in just the negative x direction, so F3x is negative of the full magnitude, 2.73 kilonewtons, and then F3y is just zero. We can then sum up our resultant, so our x component of our resultant is the sum of forces in x, so that would be the negative 273 here, the negative 2.22 here, and the positive 0.6 F1 here. Add it all up and we'll get, forgot my F1, we'll get the 0.6 F1 minus the 4.95 kilonewtons. For FRY component, that's gonna be the summation of all the Y components. That would be the negative 2.22 here, a zero here, so that doesn't count, and then the negative 0.8 F1 here. So that would be this expression. And then now we're supposed to minimize it. So we've got a couple options. One would be maybe we can make it zero. Looking at this problem, there doesn't seem to be a way to make that resultant be zero. So that's not really an option. The second option would be maybe there's some physical limitation that we could run it up against that would minimize it. It doesn't really look that way in this problem. So our last option is to try to find a local min or max. So we can find a local min or max by finding the magnitude of the resultant. So that would be FRX squared plus FRY squared. And I'm going to go ahead and square that magnitude just to make it a little easier to work with in the next step. So that would be our 0.6 F1 minus 4.95 squared, and that would be our negative 2.22 minus 0.8 F1 squared. Now we're going to take a derivative of this with respect to F1. So derivative of the magnitude squared with respect to F1. If we can maximize or minimize the magnitude, we will also maximize or minimize the square of the magnitude. So doing this, this is a value raised to the second power. So the 2 comes out in front, and then we have the value, and then we have the derivative of this. This has the F1 in there, so its derivative would be just 0.6. So we have the 0.6 here. And then same thing with this, we have the 2 here. So 2 would come out in front, we'd have our expression here, and then we'd have the derivative of the expression with respect to F1, which would just be the negative 0.8. We would set this equal to 0. You can see this is just linear now in F1, so it's easy to solve. I just ran out of board space. So when you solve it, you get F1 is equal to 1.19 kilonewtons, and then if you graphed this expression, you could see that this really did give you a minimum, or if you wanted to, you could go in and take a second derivative and you could check the sign of the second derivative to confirm that it is a minimum. Thanks for watching.